Arthur Bailey asked me to come and talk about the history of Bemis. And I thought, I don't know that much about the history of Bemis. But I thought my mom does. She's 89 and she's lives not far from here, is very active. And I know she's not going to want that on film, so you'll have to delete that part, how old she is. But I really wanted her to come today, and she said, oh no, I don't know anything about the history of Bemis. And of course she does. She was born in a house in Bemis. She knows all about it. She was born and raised here and has lived in this community not far from here. We call it the Sadie Lou Corner, right down the road here, but and still lives up the road there on Riverside. So I started talking to her about why Bemis was started, why this little community town was ever begun. And she said a man by the name of Judson Moss Bemis. His first name was Judson, J-U-D-S-O-N. Judson Moss, M-O-S-S, Bemis, was a prominent, wealthy owner of many cotton mills in Alabama. And he got this idea that he wanted to establish a model town. In other words, a little town that would have everything for everybody. Now, this was in the 1900s. That was a very long time ago. There were no iPads or cell phones or indoor plumbing or electricity or much of any of that. So it was a long time ago. And he decided to venture out and look for a location for this model town and model community. He came to this area. Why he chose this area in Tennessee, I have no idea. But he came here and thought, this is the place. There were many acres, and it was no houses, no buildings, nothing on it, just timber, just trees. And so he began to build a building. So he hired people that he could find to come and help him build what we know is the mill now. And it's a four-story building. And he didn't bring the bricks in, but they made the bricks on site. So every brick that mill is built with is made by hand. And so they're very irregular, and I thought that was extremely interesting that they made them here. And so it was a four-story brick building, and it had a basement that housed a boiler machinery that gave energy and power to the building. So later on, electricity was able to be put into the building.